Thank you. please, if you are a man and you are putting on a hat, please, can you take it off? Let everybody stand to his or her feet with all due respect. Stand to our feet as we honor God and as I introduce my pastor, Pastor Orobosa, as he opened this ceremony with prayer for us.
We give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. We thank you for the grace you have given for us to be gathered here this evening. We thank you for the enablement you gave. We all came in health and in peace. We say thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. We have come here today to honor our mother that has departed to be with you, O God. And we commit every activity that will be done here today into your able hands. The scripture says, in all things acknowledge the Lord. So we ask, O God, that you take preeminence in the name of Jesus. From this inception till the end, we declare that your will alone would be done. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We stand against every activity of the evil one.
Amen.
The scripture says, take counsel together, it shall come to naught. Speak the word, it shall stand, because God is with us.
Amen.
You are with us in this service of songs, and only your will, only your counsel shall prevail. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We thank you for the daughter and the children and everyone she left behind. We thank you because you have granted them the fortitude to bear the loss. Thank you, Father. We declare this service of song opened in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name have we prayed.
Happy Aoshi Baba.
Higher, 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 higher
we celebrate God with a clap offering. Celebrate God, celebrate God, celebrate God. Amen. Please, you may be seated. You may be seated. God bless you. God bless you. Without wasting much time, I want to take the first Bible reading. And it's taken from the book of Romans chapter 14, from verse 7 to 9. And the Bible reading will be taken by Tasha. Amen. Tasha. All right, Tasha is in Canada, so somebody is going to assist her.
It's taken from Romans 14, verses 7 to 9. And I read, For none of us lives to himself, and no one dies to himself. For if we live, we live to the Lord, and if we die, we die to the Lord. Therefore, whether we live or die, we are the Lord. For to live and Christ died and rose and lived again, the dead and the living. May the Lord bless these words in our hearts.
Amen.
So please, without wasting much time, we're taking the first hymn, which says Rock of Ages. I'm sure you are with your reflect, everybody. So can we stand to our feet as we take the song Rock of Ages? Please, CTM Choir, can you help us out?
Rock of Ages, left for me. Let me hide myself in thee. Let the
this junction, we'll be taking the second reading. It's going to be taken from the book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 13 to 18, by Osayende.
Osayende, are you online?
Yes.
Okay, go ahead and read. Hallelujah.
So the second Bible reading is taken from 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 13 to 18. I read, and to esteem them very highly in love for their sake. Warn them that are unwilling, comfort the feeble-minded, support the weak, be patient for the moment. See that none render evil for evil unto anyone. Bring yourself into a moment. Rejoice.
that it?
Yeah.
Okay, may the Lord bless you. He's done.
May the Lord bless this word, this reading in our hearts in Jesus' name.
We're going to the second hymn, Blessed Assurance. Second hymn, Blessed Assurance. City and choir, please help me.
Oh, what a fountain of glory divine, of salvation, purchase of God, born of His item here is exhortation of the word. We want to hear the word of God for a brief minute. We want to hear what God has in store for us. We want to hear from heaven. Let heaven speak to each and every one of us here today. And the man of God, God is going to use to speak to us, is no other person than Pastor Orobosa. Can we celebrate God with a clap offering as he comes out? Let's celebrate God, Pastor Orobosa.
Hallelujah. Now the good thing about it is, before she departed, she was a Christian. And as a Christian, we have the rest assurance that she's in the bosom of the Lord. And that is the reason it is important that when we lose a loved one, as Christians, we do not mourn. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. But we give glory to God because that life was a life well spent. Praise God. Shall we rise to our feet briefly? Let us open to the book of Philippians 1. We are going to be reading from 21 to 24. Hallelujah. 21 to 24, then we'll quickly see something in Romans 14, 7 to 19, and 1 Thessalonians 4, 13 to 16. Please, if you have your Bible, Apostle Paul speaking, and he said, "For me to die is gain." Hallelujah. Now, the reason I wanted us to see that scripture is because, you know, most times when it comes to the matter of death, now people do not see it as gain, especially Christians. Hallelujah. Now, the truth about it is, we have not come here on earth to live forever. Praise God. And that is the reason some people will tell you, Ekimadodo benagon. Agadwekine bakiyawu. Praise God. Now, the truth about it is, God has not ordained us to live here forever. Whether we like it or not, it will come to a point in our lives where we would translate to meet with the Lord. But the good thing about it is, as a Christian, when we die, we really do not say we die. We sleep in the Lord. Because we have the rest assurance that on the resurrection morning, when Jesus would come, everyone that is dead in Christ would do what? Would rise. Hallelujah. So that was the reason Paul was saying that. For me to die is gain. I die now is gain for me. Because when I die, I am living this earth that is full of struggles. I am living this earth that is full of pain. And I'm living this earth that is full of sorrow. And I am going to a better place where Jesus is. And where Jesus is, there is no pain. There is no sorrow. There is no struggle. Hallelujah. Amen. So what am I saying? This is not a time to mourn. That is the reason the scripture says, in all things, what do? We give thanks to the Lord. Now the reason is because that is the will of God for you in Christ Jesus. So that our mother has departed, praise God. It is not a thing to mourn over. Because the good thing about it is she was a Christian before she departed. Praise God. Hallelujah. 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 She was a Christian. So please, I want to quickly use this medium to task the daughter, the grandchildren. Please, don't mourn. If not for anything, according to what we have here, our mama lived about 87 years on earth. Praise God. That is a good result. Am I correct? I said that is a good result. 87 is a good result. Let us put our hands together for our mama. I went through our biography earlier, and I read that she was a teacher. She was a dedicated one. She was honest. She was a mama that loved her children. She was a mama of everybody. That is a life well lived. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. So the person or our mama that has died or has translated, and she has come to be with the Lord. So if there is anybody that should be thinking now, it is those that are alive. What kind of life am I living? Am I even a Christian? If I'm a Christian, what kind of life am I living? Because at the end of the day, it will come to a time when I'm going to go and be with the Lord. What would be said about me? What is the legacy I am going to leave behind? What is the legacy I am going to leave behind even for my children? Hallelujah. We've seen cases where people, in the demise of some people, family begins to quarrel. We've seen cases like that. People begin to run helter-skelter. It even comes to the burial. It is even difficult to conduct the burial. Why? Because of what was left behind. Praise God. Praise God. So my admonition to us this evening, before we rise up to pray, is if you are here, you are a Christian, you have to live a life that is pleasing unto the Lord.
You have to live a life so that at the end of the day, when it's your time to go and meet with the Lord, even your children will be proud of you. Praise God.
Junction, we want to call on Mama's daughter to come and read the biography of our Mama, our beloved mother, our beloved sister.
Praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. My mom was the very kind of person who would not tell you anything about herself. So when I was asked to write her biography, I only wrote a little that I knew. Even when she passed away, her sister, her only sister, same father, same mother, asked me, when was she born? I was shocked. I said, you don't know when your sister was born? She said, you know, your mother doesn't say anything. She doesn't want to talk about those things. Praise the Lord. That was the kind of person she was. My mom, Madam Victoria Vakamei Ogbeboni Adams, was born on October 24th, 1933, to late Forest Ranger Irabo Obasoge Adams and Madam Omosigo Igbinowahia Adams. She attended Modern School and Teachers Training College, after which she attained her teaching diploma. Late Madam Victoria Ogbebo, during her lifetime, taught in many schools, but not limited to Uwe Primary School in the 50s and 60s, Igbe Primary School and Igodala Primary School, where she retired. She was known by all as a disciplinarian, a life coach, an exemplary, honest woman with a heart of gold. But most importantly, she was a loving and dedicated wife, a mother, stepmother, grandmother, and great-grandmother. She treated everyone with love, respect, and affection. I am honored to call her mother, my queen, my hero, and my example. My mother is survived by myself, three grandchildren, three great-grandchildren, two sisters, a brother, many nieces and nephews, and they've all come here today to celebrate her. And like I always say, and like I wrote on the t-shirts, I said, good night, Ididine Okinyowe. And now, I'm going to read a tribute on behalf of the two of them in Canada who read the first and second Bible reading. Because they couldn't be here, Pastor, am I permitted to do that, sir?
Said.
A tribute to our late mother, our late grandmother. Grandmother, she was so wonderful. Her smile and her heart was always full of genuine love. Her prayers were always so powerful, it has shaped our life and keeps us from breaking down every day. Every Sunday when we call her, we will talk about the weather, how much we miss each other, and what we ate and how we're feeling. She always felt good once we called, and we felt the same. Every Sunday, we remember our loving grandma and wish we just had one more minute to talk with her. She was a caregiver, a landlord, a great friend to those she knew. She was a wonderful mother, loving grandmother and caring great-grandmother. Her love for her friends and family went very deep. She always did her best for those she loved. She is the center of our family, and we will always regard her as such. Without her, things do not feel right and feel empty. But we know she's looking down upon us and awaiting us in heaven. For now, Grandma, know that we will always love you and miss you. Continue to rest in the bosom of the Lord until we meet again. Signed, Tasha and Osayende Ihana. I'll call on her first granddaughter, Mrs. Osarugwe Igodala, to come read her tribute herself since she's here. Praise the Lord.
My grandmother, whom I used to call Mommy, was the best, beautiful and strong woman. Her death has been the hardest thing I had to deal with, but God made it easy. Because my father, Bishop Oyedepo, used to say, if you have ever lost anything, God is the reason you have not lost everything. The life lesson she passed on has helped me to become the person I have become. Mama, you always made me feel loved and special. Mama, you took care of me from when I was 5 days old. I remember when I would fall sick, you would cry, you won't eat. And then I would then eat because you didn't eat. You showed me true love and care. You may have passed on, but your memories will always live on. Thank you for the sacrifices you made for me and everything you've done for me. Rest in peace, Mama. I will never forget you and always love you. Granddaughter, Mrs. Osagwe Godala.
Praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. I know I might not be emotionally able
to say thank you,
but I want to say thank you. I want to say thank you to Ikunwe Adams' family. I adore you. I want to say thank you to Ogugo Ogbebo family. I love you. I want to say thank you to... I want to say thank you to my friends and everyone else. But most importantly, I want to say thank you to someone very special to me. Someone who raised me. Someone who used to be called against my mom. Someone who taught me, in which family I was taught a lot of my values. I was a spoiled child. I was an only child. So I was very spoiled. I didn't even know how to cook until I got there. I was given to him. He never one day treated me like a cousin. He treated me like his first child. I never lacked when I was with him. I rode in the best car. I had everything that I wanted. I got my way, even though my mom sent me there so I could, my ways could be straight. He's here today, and I would not be standing here if he was not here. I say that because he has been my backbone. He has been there for me. He's someone that I can get my way with. Even if I'm doing wrong, he will say I'm not doing anything wrong. So Pastor, please, when you pray for us, include him. And that is my daddy, Chief Nome Augustus Egwavoin. Praise the Lord.
Please, at this junction, we want to call on Mama's children.
And so, I want every one of us to stand on their feet as we are going to pray first for our mommy's daughter, Mrs. Betty, then Becky Ogbebo, before the other members of family. Please, Pastor.
Father, we give you all the glory and praise. We thank you, we bless you. You are God, and there is no one like you. We thank you for your daughter, Mrs. Becky. We thank you for the grace you have given unto her, and for the fortitude also that you have given to bear the loss. We thank you because that grace would continue in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. We commit unto your able and so God, because whatsoever is committed into your hands is safe. We declare us safe in the name of Jesus. We declare that in the morning, in the noon, at night, she is safe in the name of Jesus. We thank you because she's under your protective wings, O God, in the name of Jesus. And we declare that no weapon of the enemy fashioned against her would prosper in the name of Jesus Christ. Are there risen tongues by the power that is resident in the name of Jesus? We declare those tongues contempt. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. It is written in your words, I will satisfy you with long life. But declare, O God, that because you have declared it in your word, it is our portion. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Long life is yours in the name of Jesus. We thank you, O God, even for the children. The same way your protection is with us, that same way is with our children. In the name of Jesus Christ. In prosperity, you would prosper. In the name of Jesus. In multiplication, you would multiply. In the name of Jesus. All the days of your life, it will be from one level of glory to another. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Whatever has been spent as touching this burial ceremony, I declare, because the scripture says the Lord will supply, that the Lord will replenish in a thousandfold in the name of Jesus. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Are there enemies that are planning? Mama is no longer here. We will deal with our child. Mama is no longer here. We'll deal with our grandchildren. We silence those enemies. Amen. I said those enemies are silenced. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. This becomes their portion.
in the name of Jesus Christ. The glory of the Lord is upon you and everyone that is connected to you, in Jesus' matchless name.
Amen. We are still going to pray. Mama, hold on. Three pastors are here. So Pastor Stree is going to pray also for God's protection, that your you will not bury your children.
Amen.
Children will bury you.
And so, Lord, we give you glory. We thank you for what you have done, that which you are doing, and that which you are yet to do in the life of your daughter. Lord, by your power, by your mercies, by your grace, we cancel every evil manipulation against your daughter.
Amen.
Even the children, we cancel in the name of Jesus. I ask this from you, O God. Let your hands of protection rest upon your daughter.
Amen.
Let your wings of protection rest upon your daughter.
Amen.
For her sake, raise up your sword.
Amen.
That every evil eyes and evil hands that also stretched to her will be cut off.
I honor you because your words are yea and amen.
Amen.
Thank you for the clear weather. Thank you for everyone that come to honor this invitation, this ceremony. I pray, O Lord, that as everyone go to their individual homes, Father, let your grace go with them.
Amen.
Lord, I lift up your daughter, Becky, to your hands. Lord, your servants have prayed for her. Lord, I am praying again. I ask for more of your grace, for more of your protection, for more of your power upon her life, upon the children, upon her business, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
She will not bury her children.
Amen.
Lord, I pray, Lord, for longevity of life.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I cover her with the blood of Jesus. I cover every member of this family with the blood of Jesus Christ. They are going out with the peace. They are coming in with the safe.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Holy Ghost, fire.
Can we celebrate God with a clap of faith as we take, please, let's stand in. Let's keep standing as we take the closing hymn. The title of the closing hymn is, It Is Well, It Is Well. Before we share the benediction, It Is Well. CTPM Choir, can you help me? We're going to take the first and the last verse because of time factor.
When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrow like sea billow roll, whatever my Lord thou hast taught me to know, it is well.
Jesus, we thank you once again because you never stop prayers, you answer prayers.
Amen.
We thank you
for you are not a man that he should lie, neither the son of man that he will repent. We thank you, Father, for the peace. We thank you that you'll be with us from the beginning of this meeting down to the end of this meeting. Lord, we give you thanks, we give you praise. In the mighty name of Jesus, I cover everyone present here this moment with the blood of Jesus Christ. No one will go home to regret why he has attended this ceremony. Lord, they will go back with testimony in the mighty name of Jesus.
When my way groweth drear, precious Lord, linger near. When my life is almost gone, hear my cry, hear my call, hold my hand, lest I fall. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me on. Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. My work is all done, and my race here is run. Let me see by the light thou hast shone. That fair city so bright, where the lamp is the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me on. Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I'm weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home.
So Manigira got a mono say, Osanobwa, Unime, not any money. Not here, you toss every little Nima. The mice will be added again. Any man, Elma, over my so.
Night, my queen, my Shiro, you're the best. I didn't expect less, give me everything. He showed me love. You showed me everything. You spoiled me, you scolded me. If not for you, I would not be the person I am today. You told me, go, I'll take care of your daughter. I'm 5 days old and you did. I will always love you. I will always cherish your memory. You will always be in my heart. You have instilled in me some values that I could never have got with silver or gold, that I would never have gotten if I didn't come through your womb. I bless God for the day He put me in your womb. I bless God for the day that I gave my life to Christ. I bless God for the fact that you believed before you left, so I'm not afraid. And with that, I have peace, knowing that you're in a better place. No more sickness, no more suffering. I don't have to worry anymore, although I still will, but I love you. 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 I promised you that I'll never tell you and I did it. I pray for grace. I pray for strength. I'm alone now. It's only God alone.
You are not alone. You are not alone. You are not alone.
I saw you give it.